be both moving side together. For the sacada, what's gonna happen, it's gonna be two different vector movement. One is moving one direction, the other one is moving in the other direction. More or less, when she has like a 70, 80%, a little bit more transfer, I put my foot next to her foot, yeah? That's the space I already gonna occupy myself, and I take that space. Okay, this is principle for anybody as a beginning of the tango. We follow each other, right? So what's happening here? When the person moves, I take that space looking at her all the time, and I take that space that she gets free. She left, look what she is. Now I move my foot. Yeah. I am not trying to walk before this time to that space that I'm going to be taking. Which one I go there and coming back here.
Specific movement is the separation of the effect that you want to do and actual movement. So because we want to create not only a physical displacement, but more of a visual displacement, we're going to work towards the effect.
Meaning, what that means, the consequence. My movement, because it has this much torsion, and I move forward with this delay, very much one of the natural consequences that will happen is the pivoting.
A lot of these things are based off a desired outcome.
So we have it. In this leg, yeah, we're gonna put in this form, we have two possibilities. One, two. And one leg. And the other leg, two possibilities. One,
we are not taking on the challenge of practice everything, but we are taking on the challenge of explaining to you the overall pictures and then giving you some possibilities that we would like you to practice. But the first challenge is to explain the overall picture. So the overall picture is that we have two partners, yes? The sacada can be done by me to the partner and by my partner to me, yes? So that's already doubles the possibilities. The person who is doing the sacada, we're gonna call it a giver, or the person who executes the sacada. And the person who receives the sacada, we're gonna call that person a receiver. Then we have two directions, moving to the left or to the right with any given step. Both people can do that, right? Then the next thing that we need to understand is that we have two legs and each leg has a cross forward, cross back, and open forward, open back. So now you see there is a multitude of possibilities from each side, doubled by the fact that there is two directions, and there is doubled by the fact that there is two partners, right? So I cannot even calculate right now out of my head, like 64 times 64. Whatever that is.
Whatever that is. It doesn't matter how many they are. The good thing will be to we can explore the much possible. First walk is in a forward cross. I take the forward cross and I surrounding her. I am not dragging her with me, so you're gonna change the perspective or the direction of her body. So she's coming to you, you keep her isolated in place, you change with your tummy in around her, so she's coming to you, sacada, to you. Now she's sacada, she's pivoting, and over here is coming, you forward, back, and a diagonal form. So you do forward and back. Forward cross for her, and back cross for her. Because my direction is going in that direction. She's coming to me here and building all the way there. Let's say now, as again, as she's going there, I need to prepare myself earlier so I know they go in that direction. Now, I'm unwinding her and walking with her on the back, cross for her, and we take a resolution on the base to the cross.
What's happening in this movement, we are still traveling the same direction. The sacada and my movement goes the same direction, and then we both reversing, the sacada and my movement goes to the opposite direction. So theoretically I have the same thing, I have some sort of alteration because I am changing the direction by going forward and back. But at the same time, I am not changing the direction. I will be traveling on the same circle that the leader indicates, yes? So I am not reversing the direction, I'm just reversing my steps. My direction still will be following the same type of hero.
To me. But right now, if we're analyzing her body, is going in that direction, yeah? And my body is going in that direction. Yeah. We have both opposite direction of the movement. So right now we are doing this one. We're doing this and she's coming with the same sacada going there. But at the same time I could go in the same direction with her. But entonces right now we are both going in the same direction. One direction, another direction on her body, but on me, I continue going by now in one and in the same for me.
So we call this series a mystery of the fourth sacada, right? So what is that fourth sacada? And that name sometimes you're gonna hear, so we want you to know what is it. So if he's moving this one way, I'm gonna be doing the sacada to his now free leg, right? So to his right leg. So let's analyze these four possibilities that I have. So now I'm traveling with him, but my whole torsion, my whole turn is opposite direction. So anytime this kind of thing happens, that is gonna be that mysterious fourth sacada, where the pivot of the person who is doing the sacada has to go opposite direction than the movement of the couple itself.
Very easy way to prepare yourself for your exercises. So you can use it also as in a one short sequence for something and you add it to another place. First, very easy. By now, what we execute? Just question that to yourself to you start to understand easy how to prepare yourself to practice it. What are we executing? We're executing our sacada to what? Exactly, to her back cross, right? So see, what we have to do is prepare back coaches for her, right? One back cross, you can do the many possible, right? You can do many you want. And I know we executing the first back cross is going to my right, right? So see, I go in with my right to the right, because in this moment it's a cross system. We are going back coaches and cross system. So see, when she's going to the back, to the right, I go with my sacada to the front. Now, when she's going backward to my left, I go in sacada to the left. So I continue reading the back ocho for her as I'm executing my sacada. Right. And whenever you decide, you stop it, and you can take a rest. I mean, take a resolution by base to the cross, so you don't do your sacada, 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 sacada.
That's when you want to practice my part. Now, what are you going to do when you practice your part?
Oh, when I'm going to practice my part, to do my sacada to her, we go again. So again, what are we executing? Yeah, you need to analyze exactly what you are executing to do your actions, right? Meaning, by now, she has to do a sacada to me. So she executing forward cross to my forward cross. Entonces, let's see. We're gonna take one and two. So you can have it exactly one nice combination. Then you can just repeat one more time if you need it. And then you do one back arch or any other movement you want to take a resolution.